Hey everyone, Josh here with HostGator. Today we're going to talk about how to create and manage FTP accounts inside your cPanel. Now, FTP is probably one of the most important tools you'll use early on when you're working with web hosting because it allows you to move large amounts of files or really, really big files to and from your server and your local workstation. You can use the username and password that you use to log into your cPanel right here and take it to your favorite FTP account, FileZilla or WinSCP, and log in directly with that and the site IP. But now I'm going to show you how to create new FTP accounts where you can isolate into very specific directories. So what we'll do here is just scroll down to the files section and we'll click on the FTP accounts tab. Now this is going to take us to the page where we can actually create a brand new FTP account. Now we need to specify a few things, and the first thing I want y'all to do is to click on the dropdown for the domains tab. And we'll actually choose the domain that we want to work on today. So if you've got a hatchling plan, you're only going to have one, but if you have a baby or business plan, you could have multiple. So the first thing we'll do is choose the actual domain that we want to work on, because that's going to specify where that content is in your server. So today I want to work on hgadmin. And the next thing I need to do is actually give it a name. So the name for this FTP account is going to be really similar to an email address. So for me, it's going to be josh@hgadmin.com. And then all I really need to do is choose a password for it. So if you've got one saved and it's nice and secure, you can type it here and then click to paste it again. Or you can actually do the password generator to generate a brand new secure password for you. Now I've got one saved here on my end, so I'm just going to copy this over and then paste it again for the again section. Always tells you to have a nice strong password, always good to have for security. Now the next thing I want to talk about is the directory path. Now this is exactly what access this FTP account will have inside of your server. So as you can see here, it's going to give me access to public HTML, hgadmin, and then this folder, Josh, is essentially where I'm going to be able to have access. Now, it's going to create a blank folder that's called Josh inside of the hgadmin folder. And if I'm working on the site hgadmin.com, that's not going to be really helpful because I can't put content in the directory where it needs to be. So if I want to have either myself or a developer have access to that specific directory, we'll just remove that so I can access that folder. Now you can also keep going up levels. So if you want to have access to public HTML, you just erase it all the way to public HTML. And if you want this account to have access to the entire cPanel, so everything in the home directory, you just remove this down all the way. And essentially that's how you would manage exactly what directories this FTP account will have access to. So really up to you where you want this to have access. If you've got a developer who's working on just one site, you can give them access to just that folder. Works really easily. The next thing you want to do is talk about the quota. And for me, it's going to be unlimited because I can transfer in and out as much data as I want to. But if you want to set a limitation for someone, then you can certainly do that in MB right up here. Once you've got all that set, all we'll do is click Create FTP Account. We'll get a nice account created signal here. And then my new FTP account has essentially appeared down here. So it shows me the path that it has access to, the current usage, and how much quota I have. So for that little infinity symbol, that means unlimited. And I can also change the password, I can change the quota, or I can delete this account if I want to. Now that I've got this actually created, all I really need to do is copy this over into a text document somewhere, make sure that I have my password saved, and then we'll just go back to our front page of the cPanel, scroll down, grab that site IP, and then that, along with the username and password, is all I'm going to need to log into my favorite FTP client. So whether you're using FileZilla, CyberDuck, or any other, that's all the information that you're really going to need to have access directly to the content that's on your server, and then be moving files back and forth, essentially, as much as you want to. And that's essentially it. That's how you manage, create, and modify FTP accounts in your cPanel. I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.